നമസ്കാരം ഞങ്ങളുടെ ഇന്നത്തെ ക്ലാസ് കൈകാര്യം ചെയ്യുന്ന ഡോക്ടർ അജയൻ മറ്റ് ഡോക്ടർമാരെ നമ്മുടെ ജില്ലാ ആയുർവേദ ആശുപത്രി വർക്കല അതുപോലെ ആയുർവേദ മെഡിക്കൽ അസോസിയേഷൻ ഓഫ് ഇന്ത്യയുടെ ആറ്റിങ്ങൽ ഏരിയ കമ്മിറ്റി ഇവരുടെ സംയുക്ത ആഭിമുഖ്യത്തിൽ ഇങ്ങനെ ഒരു വെബിനാർ സീരീസ് ഞങ്ങൾ നടത്തുകയാണ്. ഇത് 12-ാമത്തെയാണ്. എന്തായാലും ഫാക്കൽറ്റീസിൻ്റെ പ്രത്യേകത കൊണ്ട് തന്നെ ഇത് വളരെ ശ്രദ്ധിക്കപ്പെടുന്ന ഒരു വെബിനാറായിട്ട് മാറിയിരിക്കുകയാണ്. പിന്നെ ഈ സമയം വളരെ തിരക്കുള്ള ടൈമാണ്. ഒരേ സമയം പല ഗ്രൂപ്പുകളിലും സംഘടനകളുടെയൊക്കെ വെബിനാർ നടക്കുന്നുണ്ട്. എങ്കിൽ പോലും നമുക്ക് വ്യൂവേഴ്സ് ഒട്ടും കുറവില്ല എന്നുള്ളത് ഒരുപക്ഷെ ഫാക്കൽറ്റീസിൻ്റെ പ്രത്യേകത കൊണ്ടാണെന്ന് നിങ്ങൾ കരുതുന്നു. പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് ഈ കോവിഡിൻ്റെ കാലഘട്ടത്തിൽ സമയം വളരെ ക്രിയേറ്റീവായിട്ട് ഉപയോഗിക്കുക എന്നുള്ളതാണ് നമ്മുടെ ലക്ഷ്യം. അതോടൊപ്പം പുതിയ തലമുറയെ കൂടുതൽ ആയുർവേദ ശാസ്ത്രത്തിലോട്ടും അതിൻ്റെ ചികിത്സാ രീതികളിലേക്കും ആകർഷിക്കുക എന്നുള്ളതാണ്. ഡോക്ടർ അശ്വതി ആണ് അതിൻ്റെ മുഖ്യ സംഘാടകമായിട്ട് പ്രവർത്തിക്കുന്നത്. ഡോക്ടർ അശ്വതി, അപ്പോൾ അത് വെൽക്കം ചെയ്തോളൂ, മറ്റേ ആളിനെ ഒന്ന് ഇൻവൈറ്റ് ചെയ്യുക കേട്ടോ.
ആ സർ,
ഓക്കെ,
താങ്ക് യു സർ. നമ്മൾ ഈ വെബിനാർ സീരീസിലേക്ക് അജയൻ സാറിനെ ഒരു സ്വാഗതം ചെയ്യാനായി അഷ്ടാംഗം ആയുർവേദ വിദ്യാപീഠത്തിലെ അസിസ്റ്റന്റ് പ്രൊഫസർ ഡോക്ടർ ഓം പ്രകാശ് നാരായണനെ സ്വാഗതം ചെയ്യുകയാണ്. ഡോക്ടറെ
നമസ്കാരം. കേൾക്കാം അല്ലേ? കേൾക്കാം, ഓക്കെ, ശരി ശരി. അപ്പൊ എല്ലാവർക്കും നമസ്കാരം. ഞാൻ അശ്വതി ഡോക്ടറിന്റെ അടുത്ത് പറഞ്ഞിരുന്നത് അജയൻ സാറിനെ കുറിച്ചൊന്ന് പരിചയപ്പെടാന്നുള്ളതാണ്. എനിക്ക് തോന്നുന്നു കേരളത്തിലാണെങ്കിലും ഒരു ദക്ഷിണേന്ത്യയിൽ തന്നെയാണെങ്കിൽ തന്നെ അജയൻ സാറിനെ കുറിച്ച് ഇനിയിപ്പോ ഇന്ന് ഒരു ഗ്രവ്യത്തിന്റെ മേഖലയിൽ വളരെ പ്രശസ്തമായി നിൽക്കുന്ന ഒരാളെ കുറിച്ച് ഞാൻ കൂടുതൽ പരിചയപ്പെടുന്നതിൽ എനിക്ക് അർത്ഥമില്ല. എന്നാലും അറിയാത്ത പുതിയ ആൾക്കാരൊക്കെ ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ അദ്ദേഹം ഒരു തിരുവനന്തപുരത്ത് പാരമ്പര്യം കൈകാര്യം ചെയ്യുന്ന കുടുംബത്തിൽ നിന്ന് വന്നിട്ടുള്ള ആളാണ്. അദ്ദേഹത്തിന്റെ ബിരുദ ബിരുദാനന്തര പഠനങ്ങൾ
ഉടുപ്പിലെ ബിരുദവും ബിരുദാനന്തര ബിരുദവും അദ്ദേഹം കംപ്ലീറ്റ് ചെയ്തത് SDM ഉടുപ്പി വെച്ചിട്ടാണ്. അത് കഴിഞ്ഞ് അദ്ദേഹം രാജസ്ഥാനിൽ വെച്ചിട്ട് ദ്രവ്യഗുണത്തിൽ തന്നെ അദ്ദേഹം PhD കരസ്ഥമാക്കുകയും ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. എനിക്ക് തോന്നുന്നു അദ്ദേഹം ഈ അഗസ്ത്യ മർമ്മ ശാസ്ത്ര എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഒരു വിഭാഗത്തില് പ്രത്യേകിച്ചിട്ട് CCRAS അതിനൊരു കമ്മിറ്റി ഉണ്ട്, അതിന്റെ ഡോക്യുമെന്റേഷനുമായിട്ട് ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടിട്ട് അതുമായിട്ടും അദ്ദേഹം സഹകരിച്ച് പ്രവർത്തിക്കുന്നുണ്ട്. പിന്നെ എനിക്ക് അതിൽ ഉപരി പറയുകയാണെങ്കിൽ അദ്ദേഹത്തിന്റെ ഈ ഒരു പ്രത്യേക എന്താ പറയുക സ്കില്ല് കാരണം തന്നെ വിവിധ കമ്മിറ്റികളിൽ എനിക്ക് തോന്നുന്നു ഒരുപാട് ഞാൻ തന്നെ ഇവിടെ അഷ്ടാംഗത്തിൽ നേരിട്ട് കാണുന്ന ഒരുപാട് കമ്മിറ്റികളിലും ഒരുപാട് പ്രൊജക്ടുകളായിട്ട് ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടിട്ടും എന്തിനുപരി നിരവധി PG/Thesis പോലും അദ്ദേഹം നിരന്തരം ഒരു ഗൈഡൻസ് നൽകുന്നതായിട്ട് നമുക്ക് കാണാൻ സാധിക്കുന്നുണ്ട്. എനിക്ക് തോന്നുന്നു ഞാൻ 2016 സഖ്യായനുമായിട്ട് ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടിട്ടാണ് അദ്ദേഹം ആദ്യമായിട്ട് അദ്ദേഹത്തെ പരിചയപ്പെടുന്നത്. എനിക്ക് അറിയണ്ടാവും എല്ലാവർക്കും കേരളത്തിൽ സഖ്യായനം വളരെ പ്രശസ്തമായിട്ടുള്ള വേറിട്ട് നിൽക്കുന്ന ഒരു പരിപാടി അദ്ദേഹം തന്നെ ആസൂത്രണം ചെയ്ത് കൊണ്ടുവന്നിട്ടുള്ള അങ്ങനെ നിരവധി പരിപാടികൾ ഇപ്പൊ അഷ്ടാംഗത്തിലെ ആരണ്യകമായാലും അതായത് ദ്രവ്യ പഠനം വളരെ രസകരമാക്കി മാറ്റാൻ വേണ്ടി അദ്ദേഹം നിരവധി കാര്യങ്ങൾ ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. പിന്നെ യാത്രകൾ ഒരുപാട് കാര്യങ്ങൾ. അപ്പൊ എനിക്കൊന്ന് കോവിഡ് കാലത്താണ് അദ്ദേഹം ഇപ്പൊ കുറച്ചും കൂടിയെങ്കിലും വീട്ടിലിരിക്കുന്നത് എന്നാണ് എനിക്ക് അറിയാൻ സാധിച്ചിട്ടുള്ളത്. അപ്പോ അദ്ദേഹത്തിൽ നിന്ന് നമുക്ക് പഠിക്കേണ്ട കാര്യങ്ങൾ ഒരുപാടുണ്ട്. അദ്ദേഹത്തിന്റെ ലാളിത്യം, ഒരു വിനയം, വിഷയത്തോടുള്ള നിരന്തരമായിട്ടുള്ള അടങ്ങാത്ത ഒരു കൗതുകം ഒക്കെ നമുക്ക് എനിക്കൊന്നും ആയുർവേദ തലമുറ ഉൾക്കൊള്ളാറുണ്ട് എന്ന് തോന്നുന്നു. എനിക്ക് തോന്നുന്നു അധികം ഇനി പറഞ്ഞ് ഞാൻ നീട്ടുന്നില്ല. ഈ ആറ്റിങ്ങൽ ഏരിയ കമ്മിറ്റി അതുപോലെ തന്നെ വർക്കല ജില്ലാ ആശുപത്രിയും ചേർന്ന് നടത്തുന്ന ഈ വെബിനാറിന് എൻ്റെ എല്ലാവിധ ആശംസകളും അജയൻ സാറിനും ഈ വിഷയം നന്നായിട്ട് എല്ലാവർക്കും ഉൾക്കൊള്ളാൻ സാധിക്കട്ടെ എന്ന് ആശംസിച്ചുകൊള്ളും. നന്ദി.
ഓക്കെ, തുടങ്ങ സർ.
ഗുഡ് ഈവനിങ് ആൾ. ഇന്നത്തെ വെബിനാറിലെ അവസരം GDH വർക്കല ആറ്റിങ്ങൽ ഏരിയ കമ്മിറ്റിയിൽ നിന്ന് പ്ലാറ്റ്ഫോമിൽ അഗസ്ത്യ മർമ്മ ശാസ്ത്രത്തിനെ പറ്റി പറയാനായിട്ട് ഒരു അവസരം കിട്ടിയത് ഓണറായിട്ട് ഞാൻ കരുതുന്നു. ശരി മാഡം, അങ്ങനെ വിളിച്ചിരുന്നു. അപ്പോൾ സ്പെഷ്യലി താങ്ക്സ് ടു important persons behind this platform. Sorry, it's a bit short that nearly more than 20 classes are over already. So, thank you Ashwathi madam, and especially thankful to Om Prakash sir for giving me a very good introduction, and Sabin sir, then Balu sir, and all other great gurus and Vaidyas of Bharatiya. So we can directly go to some of the aspects of Agastya Marma Shastra. Agastya Marma Shastra is a broad science. Just like our Charaka Samhita and Sutra Samhita, this is also a science which is discussing about the various aspects of anatomical, physiological, and pathophysiological activities of Mahama Vikhara, along with its utilization in various other disease conditions that will associated with Mahama. For that, there will be a detailed descriptions of various types of plant origins and animal origin materials, along with innumerable number of yogas, which in the form of Sarasamkalikam, Churna, Vridas, and Mahasnehas, like combinations of that. So today we can see what are the important plants that can be used for these types of Mahamadikavas. What is its importance in Mahamadikava? Why we are using the plants? So from the first part, we can see the importance of protection of anatomical and physiological activities in our body, and how it is affected when a Mahamadikava is occurring. And for that, what are the important karmas are needed? And for that purposes, to normalize the karmas, we are using the different types of plants and some of the yogas we can see. So that is the today's discussion. So with all your permissions, we can go through the discussion. I will stop the video because of the rain, some problems. And after that, when we are coming for the discussion, I will go on the video. Going to the revision. So anything is there, we can discuss at the end of the class. So I hope everyone can see the PPTs. Kana, right?
Kana, sir.
Okay. Start here. Of my grandfather Brahmasriya Keshavanada Swami and my teachers Karnakaran Vaidyan and Raghavan Vaidyan, I am able to know about some of the aspects of these marmas, especially the Agastya Marma Shastra. So when we look into the historical aspects of Agastya Marma Shastra, we can see that the great Guru Shiva has handed over the science to Parvati Devi, and from the Parvati Devi, Subramanya has learned this science, and Subramanya transformed this to Agastya Muni. And Agastya Muni made this science in a comprehensive manner and discussed all the matters with his disciples, and what the things now available in the form of various songs and books is brought by the Agastya Muni. So if you look at the literature aspects of this book, this Agastya Marma Shastra, you can see that now there will be 26 sthanas are available. So on these all 26 sthanas, there are so many informations are scattered from the basis of anatomy, physiology, and other mahamadikavas and its medicines. Everything is mentioned in this book, especially regarding the plants and its utility in the single drug forms or in the combinations of the form or in a formulations can be seen in these books. In Marma Kadigara, Marma Sutra, Marma Sutra Turavu, on these three sthanas, there are so many yogas are there. And more yogas are seen in Marma Kannadi also. And some of the rare yogas you can see in Nyarambara Sutra. Especially it is related to the Nyarambu means nerves and the channels, srodhasas. So that type of srodhas, vigaras, correcting the medicines are mentioned in Nyarambara Sutra. And you can see that Udivumuru Kettu Sutra. On that, the management of the various types of injuries related to the bones, fractures, dislocations, like things, and their medications are mentioned in that. Like that, externally and internally, numerous types of formulations are there. It's mentioned in each and every sthanas. So that is the specialty of this book. Still, there are so many things are in various traditional families, and there are so many various sthanas are in the form of palm manuscripts in various libraries also. So still so many things has to come out. So that is the richness of this science. So we can see some of the basic aspects of this Marma. So Marma has two aspects. One is an anatomical aspect and another is a physical aspect. So there will be an anatomical structure and the physiological activities is going on. So first we can see what is the anatomically importance of Marma. What is the definition of an anatomically Marma, how we can define. So it is mentioned as sakala narambin kuchangalvanam churulugalum poigagalum irunda idangalkku marmam endu peruvaan. So any srodhasas where there will be a ending, where there will be a twisting, where there will be a swollen like ganglions, or there will be a branches. So any structural entity of srodhasas, maybe a nerve, artery or vein, or maybe a lymphatic tissue, or maybe some other things like any tendons, or maybe there may be any fascias. All these places where there will be an ending is there, where there will be a twisting is there, or a swollen is there, or a branches is there. All these parts are susceptible for various type of anatomical weaknesses. And these are one of the important Marma points also because of its anatomically weak susceptibilities. So another function is functional aspect, physiological aspects. So through these all the srodhasas, we can see that a peculiar type of energy is flowing. A peculiar type of impulse is there. Is it maybe in the form of a verbs, or maybe in the form of a sushma, form of a impulse, or maybe in a flow? So all these are termed as Marma or Prana. So that's why if you look into the synonyms, you can see that Vashi, Puravi, Kati, Ushir, Maya, Prana, Kala, Shwasa, Shara, Yoga, Shiva. Everything is this Marma. So Ajari is telling that Akum in the Navalam, Sharatin, Marma Mandra, Talangalam, Sharatinuda, Ipadache, Sharamandal, Shwasavadu Tangamid means this power of movement or power of impulse that will be situating or going through these channels, and some places it is staying for a particular time, that is termed as Marma points. So through these anatomical structures, if a force or energy or a life is staying for a particular period here or here or here or these endings, then or maybe these two branches starting, then that part, the prana will be situated for a particular period. And there, any obstruction or pressure is occurring, then that Marma Vikara will occur. So here two things happening. One is the structure has got some pressures from the surrounding, or it may injured by something, and then the physiological activity will be deranged. So then that will lead to the Marma Vikara. But in other words, there will be a flowing of the things, and in normally itself, in these points, their chances of staying of the prana in these areas for a particular time, and then again it will transform into the next life. So wherever there will be staying, the house where the prana is residing for a particular period in a sloganess, then that is termed as mama. Like that, if you are looking, there are numerous mammas are there in our body. Ajare itself is telling that innumerable number of mammas are there. But on that, 108 mammas are more susceptible for various types of disorders or mamma vikaras. And when we are going to diagnose these mamma vikaras, we have to depend upon these 108 mammas. And when we are treating these mammas, we have to look into these mammas also. So the chances of mamma vikaras, nidhanam, it's related to 108. Its causes or any particular disease also 108 restricted, and for diagnosis and prognosis purpose also the 108 is necessary, and for treatment purpose also these 108 is essential, and essential mammas we have to understand. So according to the prognosis is one of the important thing. If a patient is coming, first we have to differentiate that is possible to treat by our system or not, or is it manageable by our knowledge or not. For that purpose, the Acharya has classified these 108 marmas into two. One is Padmarma and this Padmarma. Padmarma are the 12 marmas which are very vulnerable marmas, and the marma vikara is occurring, there may be a sudden death is occurring. Sometimes if the physician is able to cure also, the patient has having some deficit in their particular parts. So that is the Padmarma. Most of the Padmarmas are coming under the head and the neck areas and the chest. Then the Todumarma 96, these are other marmas on the whole body. And here, it is not that much of vulnerable and it is manageable by the treatments, various treatment methods. Like that, 108 marmas are there. So on that, there are some of the important marmas. We can say that these are the some of the primary marmas that are in the body. We know that the head is the most important part and the spinal cord is also the important part. So the Sushumna and the Shiras, these parts are the most important centers in our body. So these Uchi Marmam, Churiyadi Marmam, Chwaradinda Kalam, Pushti Marmam and Nanganapur, these are very important marmas of our body, because you can see that Uchi Marmam is the important part where there will be the exchange of hot and cold of our body is taking place in a more consistent and more prevalent level. From there, C1 area, atlanto occipital area, is the one of the important area that is called as Churiyadi Marmam. From there, C7 T1 area is the Chwaradinda Kalam. And then T12 L1 area is the Pushti Marmam. And L5 S1 area is the Nanganapurukku. So these points are most of them are having a churi, means a round like things. So these types of a round circular marmas are there in our body is these marmas. Because of its anatomically and physiologically importance, such type of a circular structures, it has more relevant in our body. And from these places, we have various types of marmas to the shagas and other parts. So that's why these are the important part when we do the treatments and other things. So why it is more important means, here you can see that there will be a concavity and a convexity is taking place in each and every part. And these concavity and convexity is joining, wherever it is joining, these are the main marmas. So here you can see a convex, then concave, convex, then concave, like that, an S-shaped structure. Structurally in shape, it is susceptible for various types of anatomical weaknesses. And whenever we are doing any exertions work, there may be a chances of shaking or a compressions or a more physiological related stress can be occur on these parts. And it will result in various types of problems. So the most of the time in the upper extremities, you can see that these two marmas are involved. Atlanto occipital and C7 T1. And in the lower areas, you can see that there will be movement of T12 is involved, and along with the L12 is involved in the longer aspects. So everything is interrelated to all these parts. And through this strong bony concavity and convexity, we can see three important nadis or trinadis are circulating. And they are most of the time making an anastomosis in these part. So the Ida, Pingala and the Sushumna is there. So here the strong anatomical structure, which is susceptible for various types of stress and strain associated with the various types of channels of small things like Ida Nadi, Pingala Nadi and Sushumna Nadi. And again, these nadis also becoming very susceptible in these areas because of its anastomosis or because of its crossing or its becoming a branching type thing, what we have discussed on the previous one. So anatomically and along with that, inside there will be various types of physiological activities also taking place. So once there will be a marma vikhada is occur, what will happen? Because these are the upper areas, there will be prana is predominant, middle there will be a samana vayu is predominant, and down there will be an apana vayu is predominant. So we have one force which is going in all direction and one force which is going in a downward direction. So like that, so many energy flowing things are taking place in an unexplained manner in our body, in a complex system. So our sciences are discussing about these types of complexities in a simple form, in a various another outlook. For these purposes, we have to look into the various types of pathogenesis of Mahabhutana. There are two samprathis are taking place in this. Why it is most important means, because when you are selecting a drug or a combination, a yoga, we should know about that there may be a proper understanding of the samprathi ghatakas are needed. So we can see two types of samprathis are mentioned. One samprathi is an acute samprathi. There will be a sudden marma vikhada and there will be a sudden symptoms and it is very severe. Then it will be like that. Veedana tarangalil nerungumagil. If any house of this prana is situating, is having any compression, then tangamal kalabattum kalendu paandu. From there, the 10 pranas. So here, in this marma book, Agastya Marma Shastra, Acharyas are discussing about the 10 pranas. Along with the prana, bhana, udana, vyana, all these 5 pranas, samana, along with that, dhananjaya, prakara, devadatta, all these upa pranas are also discussed. So here, these 10 pranas will become vitiated. Along with that, pranavattil vishankalanda chudhiileri, then the prana will vitiate and it will enter into the pranabhavasvagas of amrdana moola thannil mayakkambare. Amrdana moola means spinal cord. So when a marma vikaram is occurring, then the prana will vitiate it and it will circulate and it's going through the prana, it reaches the amrdana moola with the spinal cord and there it will produce a unconscious like feeling. Then madakkamanda adagumanda prana vayu chanjalam. So here the prana will become an irregular in their functions, and then that irregular prana will tanulipan kundalikul prana nadu tholil marandu. So the prana situated in this kundali amrdana moola will forget about its functions and then it will go upwards and it will reach moonara. Moonara means the brain. So through there it is reaches sanjara mantirupane moonara kul mounamaga prana vagai 10 mandu tholile vitta. Then it will come to the moonara, the brain, and it will forget about its all function. Then is it possible that it is the human beings are having a specific type of movement or not? We will forget about all the movements. This is an acute marma vikhada in a person's with that. So according to the place where it is occurring and according to the severity, this will facilitate it in such a form. So here you can see that a marma vikhadam is occurring. It is traveling to through the channels and it will reaching the primary marma sthanam, one of the primary marma sthanam in the spinal cord, and then it will reaching to the moonara brain and it will producing some unconscious like feeling or any involuntary movements or severe pains or loss of functions like that. This is the one of the samprapti. And another samprapti, we can say that it is sometimes it may be a chronic samprapti. Here, Tanyana Marmatin Gunam Enral, Cherna Narampadil Kattamati. First, what the thing will happen means, if a pressure or compression will be occurring on a particular sources, then the blood will, circulation will be less, or its constriction of a particular Kattavaka sources will be taking place. Then what will happen is, on that place, there will be a hotness will be generated. So in any inflammations, first the thing what it is occurring is the heat. So this heatness of that particular chudaya unna koluttudan, then the heatness is occurring, then spasm will occur. That is called as koluttu, a spasm will occur. And then the spasm will turn to increase the vayu. So the vayu will be aggravated. So here two things has happened. First is the decrease the circulation to a particular part. Then heat will generate and it will produce a spasm, and that spasm will increase the vayu, and vayu will start to produce oru narambil neeriri vada will start to produce exudation secretions, and inflammatory process will further aggravate. And as the vada will provoke it, then konana analerumbu amrutam pongi, then it will vitiate the kapha also amrutam pongi. The liquidity of the kapha will be increases, then kuluttu perumagiyodu narappu kettum, then it will be turned into a vada kapha predominant thing, and the swelling will become liquid semi solid or it become a solid, and then it will compresses the narambu the srotasas. In such a condition, edana idukkam veekal irikkilum, so there may be a pain, there may be a as spasms, there may be a difficult movement, and all these things will take place. Then if the treatment is not done on these tenses also, then it will pass into another dhadus, aruvapettu dhadu gunri, then it will go to another dhadu. If it is happened in rasarakta dhadu, then if it is not treated properly, it will enter into mamsa medha like this, and will produce various types of disorders. So in a chronic marmabikada samprapti, disease is the process. So when you observe an osteoarthritis or a lumbar spondylitis or a cervical spondylitis or even a knee cell product conditions, it is not a one day or two day disease. It is a long samprapti is behind on that. The samprapti is this one. A simple small injury to a particular part, and it will lead to the blockage of a particular vector to or any specific type of circulation to that particular part, and on that time the small heat will be released, and that will secrete a aggravations of vada, and vada will lead to the secretions of more swellings, and that swellings will aggravate the kaphas also, and together with vada and kapha, it will compresses the srotasas and distribute the 10 vayus, and if it is not treated in the proper time, it will enter into various types of dhatus like manja, and it will be taking place in various symptoms. So that is the pathophysiology of the most of the chronic diseases related to musculoskeletal, what we are seeing in the clinical conditions nowadays. So you can see that here first there may be a swelling is very small, and it is very soft in nature, but as the day processes, the swelling because of the various ahara vihara, viruddha ahara viharas, it will be increasing and it will be going to a hardness. The routine thing what nowadays is taking place means, if you observe the cervical spondylitis patients, or if you take a history of a tennis elbow or a carpal tunnel syndrome, you can see that such type of patients are undergone a constant ahara and vihara, especially the vihara. Constantly taking evening bath or constantly taking bath mixed with hot water and cold water, it led to a small physiological marma vikaram after 30 years of age, or maybe sometimes 25 years of age itself. Along with that, we are not taking the proper mucilaginous and the proper divana vajana dravyas, and we are not giving the body proper rest. then it will produce a small swelling. As the day process and we are continuing this bath and various types of Yukshahara Viharas, then the swelling will become big and it will become hard in nature. So these swellings are maybe aggravated in the Sharatradu or Varshayardu, and then again it will be concentrated, and next year again it will become big in the Sharatradu and Varshayardu, and it will produce various types of problems. Like that, it will lead to a chronicities, and the circulations and the micronutrient circulations to the particular joints will be reduced, especially in the disc areas and in the meniscus-like things that will be occurring in the joint areas. So as the day processes, the nutrient supply will be reduced, the water supplies and the nourishment of the things will be supplied, will be reduced due to the external pressures of these swellings, and it will create a degeneration. So when we are selecting the medicines, we have to depend upon these stages, and according to these stages, we have to change the medicines. So we can take an example here. So in this condition, a small loose swelling, if you use any labas like Kottanjukavi churnam or maybe Nagaradhir churnams, so these areas the swelling is on the rasam and rakta areas. So bahya rogamakam, the swelling is there and it is soft in nature. If you use these labas, it will respond very fast and we will get the relief. But if it is on a madhyama avastha and little bit become hard, most of the time these labas will not affect. So here we need more ushna tishna quality dravyam, and which will reduce these swellings. So here we have to depend upon some tailas or maybe a labas which is having more potent in action we have to do. So here to loosen these structures, we have to depend upon tiladailam like combinations, ushna virya dravyas we have to. With that will be processed with various types of amla rasas. So but when it will become too hard, just like a ice, it is very hard in nature, then we need a multi-dimensional combinations of drugs like nimbathailam, nirandathailam to loosen this, and it has to be processed with the thikta rasa. That is the importance of choosing the drugs according to the sampraptis, and then we have to formulate the yogas. So here when you see, we have already discussed two important parts, that a structural part and a functional part. We have to take in consideration of these two, structural unity and functional unity, when you are formulating a yoga. So basically we have to do dosha prashmana and prana samrakshanam in marmavikadas, and these dosha samshanam samshamana and prana samrakshana has to be done in a fast, quick acting level. So that we have to select multidimensional drugs which is having a multidimensional and altogether influencing a sudden action to these particular conditions, especially to restore the consciousness and restore the indriyas and indriya connection to our body and mind. So this is the prime importance when we deal with the marmavikaras. For that, we have to depend upon certain important karmas. The most important karma is whenever a marmavikaram is occur, the patient is come with an unconscious or semi-consciousness state or a delirium of various types of our indriyas, then we have to do a samnya prabodhanam. Samya Prabodhanam is the most important thing in such type of conditions, to bring back the person's capacity to correlate the indriya, indriya artham and atma connections. So these indriya, indriya artham, manas, atma connection has to be regained through some sudden pramadi quality dravyas, samya prabodhana dravyas. So in marma also, we have to use shundi, marija, vaja like drugs. So the combinations of shundi, marija, vaja will be blown through the nose. Samya prabodhanam, we need that these types of shundi, marija, vaja like drugs. And another is important is madharam. Madharam, we have to look into the yashtimadu, jivanti, parni, dvayam, etc. like drugs. Yashtimadu, jivanti, ശാല പറഞ്ഞ കൃഷ്ണ പറഞ്ഞില്ലേ വളരെ വ്യത്യാസം. ജീവനീയ ആൻഡ് ബല്യം, എസ്പെഷ്യലി ദ ബല്യം, വി ഹാവ് ടു ലുക്ക് ഇൻ ടു ദ മധ്യമ പഞ്ചമൂല ദ്രവ്യാസ് ആൻഡ് ബല ആൻഡ് അംഗമർദ്ദ പ്രശ്ന ലൈക് ഏരിയാസ് വി ഹാവ് ടു ഡിപെൻഡ് അപ്പോൺ എരണ്ടമൂലം, ഫ്രീക്വൻലി യൂസിങ് ട്രപീസ് എരണ്ടമൂലം, ദെൻ മിർഗുണ്ടി പുനർനവം. These are the important drugs which is used. Another important area we have to look is the shodhaharam and mutram. So because in all the inflammation there will be an edema, so we have to reduce edema. So we have to sometimes depend upon the conditions. If it is a vata kapha predominant, we have to look upon punarnava like drugs to reduce that edema or leku panchamula. But it is a pitta associated, then we have to look upon trana panchamula like. And if it is a vataja, pure vataja predominant, then we have to look upon gokshala like mutrala. So like that, this shodhaharam and mutrala, depending upon the conditions, we have to depend upon various drugs. Another is the important is the anulomanam. Anulomanam, we have to closely use erantam. Erantathaila is the one of the important thing we are using. Then achamodam, shatakushpam like dravyas also. Another area is the sthandaniyam, vrnaropanam and rektasthambaram. So here laksham, gudiji, eshtimadu, panchakshiri, vasa like drugs which is producing the rektasthandanam and the same time it can promote the sthandaniya action and vrnaropanam also it has capacity. Then another is the deepana bhajana property. So here deepana bhajana is most of the places we have doing with the Shundi Trikadu, Panjavalam like drugs along with Shattandulam. The six grains are there that we can discuss afterwards. These grains also will be used. And another is the area where there will be a Vada Haratum. So in the most Marma conditions, we need these types of combinations. One is pure Vajja related and another is Vada Kapha related, another Vada Pitta Hara and the Pridosha Hara. These are the most permutation combination seeing in most of the Varma Vilasas. So if it is a pure Vadaharam, then we have to depend upon Rasna, Sahajaram, Gokshiram, Erandamulam type drugs. If it is a Vada Kapha associated, then we have to look into Erandam, Devadaru, Margundi, Leshanam, Indravalli like drugs. If a Vada Pittaharam means, we have to look Yashtimadu, Bala, Chandanam, Sahariva, Jeevandi and Vishnukrandi like that. So these are the observations what we see in the yogas, innumerable yogas what is mentioned in this Avastamana Shastra. These drugs are utilized there. If it is a Tridoshahara, we need that. Usually the Gudiji, Siradvayam, Bilvam, and Uttamamarani Kubili like combination size. So like that, these are the importance for the yoga. So here some of the important ganas what we are using is Dashamulam is the most important gana because it's one of the best Vadahara Shodhahara group. Brahat Panjamulam and Laghu Panjamulam extensively using. Another combination is the Dashamushpa. In the South Indian scenario, we have these odd 10 small plants and these 10 plants Dhruvam, Vishnugrandhi, Lakshmana, Sahadevi, Shashasruti, Viparita Lajjalu, Rangaraja, Musali, Pagda, Indravalli. What the specialty of this Dashamushpa means? It can enter into these various minute channels and can pacify these dasha vayus. And it can able to pacify the manasika doshas, sattvarja tamas. On that also, it is having a very good action. So in the manasa level and in the gross level, these 10 are having very nice action and some of them are very good. Mental pacifier also acting on the brain areas, three marmas, one of the three marmas. So these drugs, these 10 small herbs are having its own importance in the manasigam and the sharira. The another is the arivagaya, the shattandula, the combinations of ela, vidanga, baguchi, danikam, indrevam, like these drugs. So these drugs are also having the specific importance and the combination of trisneha prayoga and Panja Sneha Prayogas. With Sneha, three combinations of the Snehas, Panja Snehas, the five combinations of the Snehas with the Jankamam also. Various Jankama Dravyas are using. Because Anasti Madhya, if you want regeneration, most of the time, sometimes muscle wastings of the Mamsadhu also, we need Jankama Dravyas to balance this. So Kukkuda and Aja, are the two jangamas extensively used in the Burma conditions. So now we can see the some of the trucks. The important is the shatangula. It's called as Ariyaru or Arivakaru. These six grades are used extensively in various types of disorders. So Yelam, Vedangam, Indrevam, Vapichi, Dhanigam, Jyotishmal. All these are six. What it, why it is special means? In Abhyantara Roga Marga, in Bahya Roga Marga, in Madhyama Roga Marga, these six grains combinations will act very nicely in the Deshavayus. So Yelam, Vedangam, Indrevam, Vapichi, Dhanigam, Jyotishmadi, all are aromatic, snigdha predominant, kadu diktarasa dravyas with ushna properties and shida property combinations with a kadu vibhagam and some having madhura vibhagam has having a capacity to do the srodo vishodhanam sankha, removing the sankham and to do a proper anlomana of the vadas. Because of this, these six are very important in so many yogas, especially in chronic cases, to remove the amatam and kapatam. This six is important. Another important drug is the yashamuk, or in Sanskrit we call it as kundali, a type of chanju. This is called as asima tatrakana. So you can see that in each node there will be a four thorns will be there. On the tip of the leaf also a thorn is there. So this itself is indicated that the leaf is very nutritive in nature and it has to be protected from the animals. Because of that, it is producing such a type of, this is one of the excellent drug for pacifying the vada. The roots also having that capacity to pacify the vada, and these roots are asayam too. So a recent study is showing that this root is having a capacity to regenerate the coverings of the nerves. So if you look this drug, one oil is mentioned, Ishanguver Thaila in Marma Kadigara, for all types of Marma Vighadas. So in all types of Marma Vighadas, if it is related to the nerves, we can include this root of this plant in all our Ayurvedic Kashayams also. Then it will be a very good thing. And in Marma Abhikadas of 45 marmas related to the chest area, this sorasam of this. So take the sorasam of this and mix it with the tiladailam and taking will helps to pacify the marma abhikadas of the virus area. One of the frequent utilizing of a food material for these types of purposes is means the chest injury or the injuries to the suprapubic areas of the bladder or the uteruses, then this leaf is taken and it will be mixed with the equal quantity of white rice and then it will be powdered well and then it is taken and fried it, and you can make dishes like dosa or puttu or make some kurku like things, means some lehya type preparation with the guda or tala shakara, and then it can be taken. It will be very good to pacify and to rebuild the structures. So this is one of the excellent drug that can be used for the nerve related problems. So usually in Ayurvedic classics we are not using this plant very extensively, but it is a very frequent seeing and a common plant in the dry lands and of India, and we can utilize it with the low cost also. Another is the vasa. So we are knowing about the vasa. Vasa is a very important drug in some types of bleedings, and so especially again in the chest injuries by hitting or something like that, and then if it is not treated, then it will lead to shaya like conditions also. So in such conditions, the vasa root and vasa leaves are used extensively, especially in the vasa moola kashayams along with the meat soup is advised in various types of chest related injuries. And if a marma vikadam is occurring on the pushti marma, T12 L1 area, and the body has increasing with ushnam and meghavadam, the pushti marma, why it is called as pushti marma means, if marma vikadam is occurring and it is not treating properly, the pushti of our body will decrease and it will lead to prameha like conditions. In such conditions, we have to use this vasa leaves processed with jeeraga. So what it will be doing means it can regenerate our structures that related to these types of deformities. So Vasa Swarasa will be taken, and if you are taking 100 ml of Vasa Swarasa, 50 grams of Jeeraga is mixed with that, and it will be kept inside a Narigela. So a coconut has to be taken, and it will be opened with some screws or something like that. A hole has to be done, and on that inside the water has to be removed. Inside it is packed with Vasa Swarasa mixed with this Jeeraga, and it will be closed and do a Kudapagam. Then after that Kudapagam, we take that Narigela, cut open it, and then remove this churna, and it will be mixed with honey or with any other medicines you can use for various types of this Ushna Megha Vahas. So this is mentioned in Marma Kadigara. And another important thing is, some of the time the fracture management has needed so many medicines, or any injuries to the soft tissues also need medicines. So one of the excellent bark that we can utilize is this jingini. In Sanskrit, we will call it as jingani. In Malayalam, we will call it as udiyan, udiyan patta. And in Sanskrit, another name is gudamanjari. So gudamanjari koyanasyam is one of the important agravushadam in bahu related problems. So here also, in the Marmambikadas, the splint, if you want to prepare in certain fractures and injuries, it will be prepared with the mixture of this bark along with certain other drugs, and then it will be applied on the external part of our body, and then it will, the bandages will be done. Even in the back pain also, this bark will be taken and it will mix with the egg white, and you can keep it on that Kadidarna area, Marmas, then the swellings and the pain of that area will be reduced. So this bark poultice and the bark kashaya dhara is also advised for various types of fractures. Another shodharam vedana sthapanam amahara dravya is cardiosperm helicarpa indravalli. So in certain conditions when amavada is occurring, the terminal leaves of this plant has to be taken, and it will be put in the ganges, rice gruels, and it is taken, then it is good for amavada. So sometimes it is having a little bit of thicker, so the patients will not like. So you can make it into a bottle and keep it in the ganji and prepare the ganji, rice gruel. Then afterwards, if you're taking out, add a little bit of coconut milk, and then if you give to the patient, then it will be palatable, and it is good to reduce the swellings, especially in amavada conditions. And another thing is in the pindas vedas, especially the pindas vedam related to the specific type of bahya roga marga utpanna marmabhikadas, like simple swellings occurring on the external body and it is very loose in nature, then we can use this leaf for pindas vedas. And another important drug is this kumari, a wonderful drug which can promote regeneration of the tissues, reduce the swelling, reduce the pain, and it will act as a very good sandhaniya dravya to reconstruct the structures. So here also we using the swarasa and the same time the kumari sara, chenninaya kumari sara. So this is both used, you know that in Muruvana this is using, and the swarasa you can apply for various types of injuries also. Another vedana sthapana dravya is kubilu, strychnus naxovita. All the parts are having a very nice property to reduce the pain, especially the seeds are using for that process. The seeds processed with the erandathailam, and that erandathailam if you apply on the severe pains, It's very effective to reduce the pain. And if it is more ama related, then the seeds has to be put in neem oil and then boil it, then apply it, especially in the some synovial effusions like conditions also. So then also it is one of the very good thing. So to reduce the pain and the swellings, especially related to Ratta also, this is one of the excellent drug we can choose. So the usage of this in fruits, seeds and leaves, bark, we can see in various oils of the preparations. Another is Manduga Varni. One of the important drugs which is needed for the regeneration and the brain acting. So the marmas, one of the important marma is our shiras. So on the shiras area and the upper aspects, it is having a marvelous result. So in some of the marma vikadam, especially in the C1 area, atlanto occipital area marma vikadams, the spine areas are marma vikadam, and it will lead to the bahu shosham, the depletion of the tissues of the deltoid area or the infraspinatus or supraspinatus muscular areas. Then if you give this Manduga Varni in the form of kalkam for 21 to 41 days, then it can regenerate or increase the tissues of that particular part. So various yogas for head application, oils, internal other things, Manduga Varni is one of the important thing that is used, especially in the spinal related, spinal cord related problems. And it is, everyone know it is a medial tree. Another is the belia, the most belia dravya which is needed. It's one of the best vata pitta hara dravya. So whenever a patient is complaining about any giddiness or a burning sensation, we can infer that it is a pitta related. So we have to depend upon this bala like things. So we know that innumerable number of yogas are related to the balas. I'm not going through the details of this. We already know the Shira Bala utilization. So this is one of the drug we have to see, is one of the important drug that has to be included in Ayurvedic treatment purposes. This is the Shivanar Vayambu, Shiva Muligai, Shiva Tandubi. These are the Sanskrit names. So this Shivanar Vayambu is one of the important drug that is needed for Rakta related to the Marma Vikadas. Especially the Marma Vikadas on the Shipra Marma, that's called as Kavali Marma. So on the Shipra Marma, if it is not treated in the proper time, then it may lead to various types of skin problems in the palmar aspects. So in Malayalam it is calling as Ullangai. Ullangai vada vedupu vandu kottume. So there may be cracks on the palmar aspects inside the hand, and it will be broken into various types of problems. So Shipra Marma, this Kavali Marma, if it is not treated properly, it may lead to plantar psoriasis like conditions. On that Shivanar Vayambu, it will be mixed with the equal quantity of Aranya Jeeragam, and then it will be made into a paste with the sheeram, and if you apply, it will be produce a very good result. It will subside the very fast. This is one of the single drug use. This can be, this use of this drug can be seen in various chronic disease conditions like psoriatic arthritis that will be occurring due to Marma Vikaram also. We have to depend upon these types of drugs. So this is one of the drug that is the main ingredient in Kukkudadi Nai, Koli Nai, one of the Koli Nai preparations that will be done with the hen. On that, this is one of the main ingredient also. Another important is the Valli Prasadi. It's also a very common drug in the Jangala Desha, a dry lands. This can be an edible one, and it is one of the best kabhara drug, Thoodugula. So this Solan Trilobatum, we can use it for various types of respiratory related disorders and minute, small respiratory srodas related problems also. This is one of the excellent drug. The whole part is useful. especially the leaf and the flowers are using for various types of vegetable preparations, rasam also, especially flowers. In Tamil Nadu, it is used for rasa preparation, is rasam like curry preparations, and it is very good soothing and kapahara. Even in the nowadays scenarios of the various COVID market symptoms also, we can look upon this drug, this thoodhuvilai, for various types of disorders. In Siddha preparation, thoodhuvilai lehim is there. It is a very effective lehim in kapar related problems. This is the pasuka, dardhara, a drug which is having a shodhakara, a drug which is having to correct the anatomical small structures of our body, and simultaneously it is a rasayana dravya. So vasuka tardaval is one of the ingredients. This is the real tardaval which is used in the murvana. So in the murvana preparations, Parmakos hispida, this is the plant that has to be used. Usually in most of the places, different types of Parmakos are using. So what we have to see is the plant margin of the leaf is wavy in nature and it is having numerous hairs. This is the identifying one of the features. So if you observe the leaves, you can see that such a wavy in nature and a long lanceolate like things, and sometimes at the terminal end it may be like this. Terminal end it may be like this, but afterwards the leaves will be become wavy in nature. And the most important thing is, if you see the flower origin, the origin of the flower from the axil without any pedicel, without pedicels, it will be directly arising from the axils of the leaf. So from the axils, it is directly arising with, it's a sessile flower without any pedicel. So that is the real identification of Parmakos hispida, and this is the most effective source that what we can use for murvana and other leaf. So here, just like what we are discussed in the chakralata, urinya, cardiosperm helicata, the same way this drug is also very effective in internal soil with various types of problems. So that's why it is called as pudal churiki or natta churi. So the problems that may related to the internal abdominal koshta and where there will be vata is deranged due to the any marma vikaras, the ganji gruel prepared with this vasuka is advised for that conditions. Even in Amavada also, this rice gruels are very effective. The most important drug in the Siddha system and in the Marma is the Haridamanjali, Kuppameni, a common drug also, but it is one of the best drug that can pacify the tridoshas, but the dose and the formations of the usage we have to look. So in the Marma Shastra, if you see, Acharyas are mentioned so many Tirumeni annas and various types of Kaya Tirumenis. This is one of the important drug. Kabaharatam is possible and Rakta Shodhanam is possible, Padaharatam is possible by these drugs. But in the overdose, if you give the swarasams or something, it can provoke the tapama also. So in the small doses, externally and internally it can use. And the one of the important thing is, it is one of the drug which can normalize our mental activities. If anyone is hyperactive, anything which is due to the neurological deficit, there will be a hyperactivities will be there. When sannivada vikaras are there, kayatrimeni anna has to be applied in the head. Why it is means, because this is the drug which can pacify such type of mental related problems. So this is one of the important Kalipa, Indica, Haridamanjari, another common drug we can see in almost all places where there will be more dirt and waste is there. And another is the Agashavandi, Moodilla Thali. So if you look in these plants itself, you can see that innumerable structures similar to that of our srodhasas. The stem will be like various such type of things, combinations of various types of such type of combinations. So these will look, it shows that it is one of the best drug that can regenerate our nerves internally and externally is using, and one of the famous Padmarma Kashaya. So already we have discussed Padmarma is very difficult to treat on that Kashaya, it is one of the ingredients. And another is the Veliparithi, Uttama Marini, Pergularia Dami. It also has having a capacity to reduce the solens, especially related to the recta. So internally, when the clot is occurring, the leaf of this plant is used for various types of purposes, especially in respiratory related or chest related area, in hridayam and pupusa, where there will be a clot or such type of scenarios occurring, the leaf surasam is giving. This is the black variety of manduka varni. It's called as karimkudangal, neelamandi, geophylla reniformis. This also is using in padumarma kashaya. It's having a capacity to regenerate our body tissues. Marma is an important area where vada is involved. We have already seen that various types of vadas are classified. So we have to need a anushna shita dravyam of sneham, that is narigela. We need a ushna madhura rasa pradhana dravyam, which is pila. We need a tiktarasa ushna pradhana dravyam, which is neem. The sneha yonis from narigela tailam, tila tailam, and the nimba tailam are essential in various types of marma vikaras. So in marma treatments, if you look singly or the combinations of these three are extensively used to pacify the vatas, both externally and internally. Another important tailam is the eranda tailam. So we all know that eranda tailam is extensively using in Ayurveda also. The same in the Marmabhikadas also, the eranda tailam is used extensively. So this is more ushnatvam with the madhura rasam and madhura vipaha and having an excellent vada and vamana property. So there are so many yogas out there with this stress. And another sneham is the ingudi. Ingudi is the drug which can, the sneha source which can promote the healing of the internal soft tissues. So vrana robana property, shobanam also is there. So there are two sorts of ingudis are there. In Kerala scenario, we are using this sarcostoma clay odal, valli odal of Kerala varanasa. So this is the source what we are using. But in the other areas, in Tamil Nadu and the dryland areas, this Balanitis aegypti, yeah, this is the real ingudi that is mentioned in Ayurveda. The seeds is taken out and the oil is prepared, and that oil is used for various types of this. So if nowadays it is possible to get this thylum in Kerala scenario conditions also, so it is better that we can utilize the ingudi thylums that is coming from the North India for these various types of combinations. So these five oils, ingudi thailam, eranda thailam, nimba thailam, narigela thailam, and tila thailam, panchasneha prayogas are very essential if the vada is deranged and it will reach in the madhyashrada areas. So when we discussing about these things, marma, usually most of the time missing is one of the important link. How much kalpanas and how our acharyas are used to these things for various types of regeneration of the tissues. That is telling pochappa ennayodu kulambum neyum porundave kashayamodu kodiyum poochum achappa kaimurayum cheimurayum sonnen. So acharya guru is telling that enna oils, then kulambu, the mixture of these things, and ney, different types of ghee preparations, decoctions, churnam, labams, these are to be given kaimurayum cheimurayum sonnen. All should be given in a proper way. Not only simple massages or stimulations is the marma. Marma need a combination of stimulations and massages along with the selection of medicines to a particular kalam with specific dietic regimen and rest. Then only it will be a very good treatment. Along with that, the formulations like arkam, tea dailams, like preparations are there. So we can see some of the important yogas. One is the marmani kashaya, a small marmani kashaya. Especially the marma vikadam is occurring above the umbilicus, this is used. Vasamulam, adiyaru, we have discussed adiyaru, shaktangulam, this is the adiyaru. Then pippali, tripala, yashti, rasna, akrav. Here the akrav means agarakaraka. Anacyclo pyrethrum, anacyclo plus pyrethrum. This is the source we have to use. Then only we will get the desired result. Anacyclus pyrethrum, then kangolam, shundi. So these 75 grams each we have to take. And the vasamulam 60 grams has to be reduced to 60 grams put in 1 liter of water. Then mixed with that will be reduced to 300 ml. Then that 300 ml we have to add these powders of Adiyaru equally to Bala, and it will be divided into 14 equal parts, and one part mixed with these 300 ml kashaya, boil and reduced to 150 ml. And 75 ml morning and 75 ml even for 21 days. Why these 21 days? Because the soft tissues like lungs areas or any interstitial areas of our body, especially between the chest and the soft tissues of our uterus area, we need a 21 days for the regeneration of these tissues. So 21 days we have to give this medicine. Another is the Paduvarma Kashaya. Paduvarma is a very difficult marma to treat when the marma vikara has occurred. Only one yoga that is mentioned in for this Paduvarma is Paduvarma Kashaya. That's the Neelamambi, Geophylla reniformis, Sahajaram, Prashnaparni, Shahalaparni, Agashavalli, Kaskuta, Ruplaksa, Kiradadiktam, Medika, Tokku, Rasna, Talisavatra, Laksha, Jeerakam, Shallagi, Sahajam, all in equal quantities, and it will be prepared in the Kashaya and it has to be given for injuries that relate to the head and chest areas or in the vasti areas. Then the Udugumuru Kashaya. One of the Kashaya that is used for fractures and dislocations. So this is an acute condition. When the patient is coming with this, this Kashaya is good. Shundi, Yelam, Vishnukranti, Udumbarato, Nimbag, Privrut, Kiravritam, Amrata, Kulattam, Marijam. All are common drugs. There are various types of Murvanas I mentioned. One of the important Murvana is Nalpamaradi Murvana. When the patient is having a pitta involvement, along with the Marmabhikhada and the burning sensation is also there, then this is the best Murvana is mentioned. Nalpamara means Ficus pungalensis, Ficus religiosa, Ficus lacquer, and Ficus racemosa. All these four marks has to be taken and it will be mixed with the tender coconut water, 8 liter, then coconut husk juice, fresh husk juice, 8 liter, then prepare kashaya and reduce to 1/8. It will, for reducing this, you have to take 3 days. 1/8 has to be reduced within 3 days, not in a 1 day. Then that kashaya has to be taken out, then add Chitragamula, Kubigumula, Karanja bark, Shigru bark, Kevadaki, Kashakasha, Shundi, Shallagi, Sahindava, and coconut oil. In the coconut oil, we have to prepare the oil. This is the Kumariyadi Murvana. What the Murvana, what we are using nowadays. So actually, the real reference of the present utilizing Murvana is from Marma Karnadi. This is the Marma Shastra. But in all the books, it is mentioned that it is the Anupuda Yoga, not like that. This is the Marma Karnadi. It is mentioned about this yoga. And we are traditionally prepared this. And this was introduced first by my grandfather, Keshavan Vaidyan, to the Ayurvedic College, and then it will be included in the Trivandrum Ayurvedic Pharmacopoeia, and presently it will be used by every pharmacist. So one difference that when translated it is happened means, in spite of Kubilu as a Kalka derivative, it has been included as Shatavari afterwards. But if you add Kubilu, then it will be act as a very good Vedana Sthavana also. The other things you already know about the reference of then one talam. It is mentioned for if Marmabhikhada is occurring and eye problems are occurring, there will be a drooping of eyelids, or there may be a excessive movement of eyes, or there may be a jikva stambha, then Shashashruti, Emilia Swangifolia, Bala Billu, Bala Billu Kalam. So the Bala Billu Kalam, tender roots of the Billuam has to be taken, and Tukshiri Sattva, that has to be taken, namada kugamura tokshiri satto, janjiragam, laksha, shatabushkam, kashakasha, all 5 grams, and do a bhavana with kumari swarasam, then boil it, then make it to a lukewarm, and then it has to be done tala on the shiras. Then some of the labors. Shigruvadi leva, one excellent leva for reducing the swellings. Shigru tok, shundi, shallagi, kumari sara, bhavana with chincha swarasam. Another is if any pitta association, then use amrita leaf, agashavalli, durva, prasarani, ubagunji, and bhavana with tandulogam. So pitta rakta involvement, then amrita dilevam, kapha or vada kapha predominant, then shikruva dilevam. Then another is the moringa kili. This is also very good pindas vedam, as can be given for swellings if it is related to the bakhya roga marga. If the marmabhikhada is occurring and the swelling is lodging on the rasa rakta mamsam, then we can use this Shikrubhattura, Shallaki and Kumari Sara mixed together with the Nimbu Sorasa and boil with Narigala Daila, and can we give this. external vendors were. In chronic cases, it's a deep-seated disorder. There we need Deepana Bhajanam and multidimensional drugs which can do a Srodha Shodhanam to remove the Sankham and remove the Amapo. We need a multidimensional combination. So Trigadu, Tribhala, Jadipala, Jadikosha, Lavangam, like combinations along with Kaduki, Ushtam, Jamodam, Nimbam, Kiradam, and Uttamamarini, Pergularia Damia, Damia Extensa, Kundala. These drugs are very important. Uttamamarini, Damia Extensa, then Kundala, Simata, Trakanda, Madakini, Justicia, Genderosa. These three drugs has having a very good Shodhara property. Then this Kukulu Ashwagandham and the Dashamoolam Laksha combination. This is one of the good drug which can promote a Deepana Bhajanatvam and at the same time can do the Srodha Shodhana. And this is the Dashamoolam Kukutu, a Sneham which is in the combination of Yarandam, Nimbam, Minkudi, Tuvaraga, Tilavera. So there will be various Sneha yonis from the plant origin and the Gridham also. Gopridham is also added. And this combination of this Panchasneham as used for Vilayanam, Dosha Vilayanam of the strong Sankhadavastas of the Dadus. So in such Dadukadattum, where there will be Asti Manchagadam and there will be very strong in Dosha Sankhadattum, Sankham. Then we have to need these types for Vilayana. Chitraga is also one of the ingredients in that combination. And in some fibrous conditions, means some of the structures will become very fibrous in nature and stiff in nature and very difficult to move. Then this oil is mentioned. Agashavari, Bella, Bhukumari, these combinations of Sorasam, along with the Nimbu, Shikru leaf, Shallaki, Kashkash. Kashkash means this Hibana Bija, Shundi, Kumari Saram, Shatavushpa, all mixed together. And again, it is a combination of Aranda Dairam, Nariyala Dairam, and Parahavasa and Pira Dairam. So be processed and then it will be applied. Then it can loosen the fibrous structures. So sometimes we can see that some after the plaster removing and other things, mild union and fibrous structures are there, then these things can be used. So like that, if you see these Marma Shastra, Agastya Marma Shastra, there are plenty of information are there. It can't be explained in 1 or 2 days. There are so many things are there mentioned. And some of the important yogas and some of the important plants that we can utilize we have seen now. So maybe this will be helpful for those who have heard this one. I think it may be a beneficial thing if you include this in the treatments of your clinical practices. So thank you once again for all those great persons who have heard these things and those who are given an opportunity to share the importance of this. So thanking JDH, Varkala and AMI Arting Area Committee for giving an opportunity to share the information regarding the Agastya Marma Shastra. So if any interrupt is there, we can discuss.
സാർ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് ഉണ്ടോ എന്ന് നോക്കാം സാർ. ഐ ഹാവ് എനി ഡൗട്ട് പ്ലീസ് ആസ്ക് സാർ.
കുബിലു സീഡ്സ് ആർ യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്, നമ്മൾ അതിന്റെ വിത്താണ്, അതിന്റെ നമ്മൾ ആ വട്ടത്തിന് കണ്ടില്ല, സീഡുകളാണ് ഉപയോഗിക്കുന്നത്. ഇല്ലെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് അതിന്റെ മാർക്ക് എടുക്കണോണ്ട് കുഴപ്പമില്ല. അപ്പൊ നമുക്ക് അത് നമുക്ക് ഡിപ്പെൻഡ് ചെയ്യുന്നതുകൊണ്ടാണ്. നമ്മളിപ്പം കുറച്ച് നല്ല വേദനാ സ്ഥാപനമാണ് ഉദ്ദേശിക്കുന്നത് എങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് അതിന്റെ സീഡ്സ് എടുക്കാം. അല്ല, കുറച്ച് കുറവാണ്, നമുക്കൊരു മുറിവിലൊക്കെ കൂടെ അപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യാനാണ് നമ്മൾ ഉദ്ദേശിക്കുന്നതെങ്കിൽ അതിന്റെ ബാർക്ക് എടുക്കുന്നതാണ് നല്ലത്.
താങ്ക് യു സാർ, വളരെ വളരെ ഇൻഫോർമേറ്റീവ് ആയിട്ടായിരുന്നു സാറിന്റെ ക്ലാസ്. വളരെ ലളിതവുമായിരുന്നു, നല്ല രീതിയിൽ മനസ്സിലാക്കാൻ പറ്റി. ഒരുപാട് നന്ദിയുണ്ട്. വർക്കല ഡി എച്ചിന്റെ പേരിലും അമ്മായി ആറ്റിങ്ങൽ ഏരിയ കമ്മിറ്റിയുടെ പേരിലും നന്ദി അറിയിക്കുകയാണ്.